This is his victim impact, or not his victim impact statement, this is his statement, and the first sentence here says, I take full responsibility for my actions. It was September of 2009 when Annie Lay's body was found in a wall at Yale University. Overwhelming evidence would link Raymond Clark to her murder. A year and a half later at New Haven Superior Court, Clark faced Lay's family, listening to the agonizing details of how her family has suffered since her death.
I think what you saw today in the courtroom was a display of a really enormously gracious, dignified family who was suffering immeasurably.
Lay's father, mother, brother, and uncle spoke before Clark's sentencing, each statement as difficult to hear as the next. Lay's dad tearfully said, quote, our pain remains fresh, changing every aspect of life within our family. Her mother, Vivian, quote, you took away my only daughter, Annie. I will never hold my grandchildren. Or this thought from Annie's cousin, Dan. My grandmother, so great is her sorrow that she can scarcely stand to hold a picture of Annie for fear that it will renew the anguish.
Well, obviously, there's no amount of jail time or punishment that will ever bring Annie back.
After almost an hour of victim impact statements, the man who killed her rose and spoke, reading from a prepared statement. He said in part, I alone am responsible for the death of Annie Lay. I took a life and continued to lie about it while Annie's friends, family, and fiancé sat and waited. I'm sorry for taking Annie Lay's life. The family's attorney says the statement failed on one key point.
There will never be an answer. I mean, even when Raymond Clark spoke today, while he certainly appeared remorseful, he didn't provide any answers. There were no answers given as to what caused him to do what he did.
Clark, now 26 years old, was sentenced immediately after his statement to 44 years in prison. He won't get out until 2053.
I think that the family will never be able to recover their sense of loss for Annie. But all the best that we can hope for is that there's going to be safety changes at Yale, and that's what we will hope to ensure.
Now again, the victim impact statements took about an hour before Clark spoke, but if you want to read all those victim impact statements as well as Clark's statement, you can find those on our website at WTNH.com. We're live in New Haven. I'm Jamie Muro, News 8.